Welcome to the second lecture on artificial neural networks. Let us first go through that what we have covered in lecture 1. In the last lecture, we have gone through the introduction of the artificial neural networks. After going through the introduction of the artificial neural network, we have defined what exactly a neural network is. Then we have seen the original neural network, that is the brain, in detail. We have gone through the model of the same also. Then after the original neural network, we have started artificial neuron, and we have seen the model of an artificial neuron. After that, in the classification of ANN, we have covered architecture of a neural network and activation functions. So in today's lecture, we will conclude the classification of ANN, and then we will proceed further with some ANN models. So let us proceed with today's lecture. So today's lecture comprising of the last topic for the classification of the artificial neural network. So in that, we are going with the training and artificial neural network first. After going through that, we'll go for the Megalopitts neuron model, and we will see the different logic function implementations using Megalopitts neuron model. After that, we will go through some applications of neural networks, and then finally we will compare the artificial neural network and biological networks. This whole lecture 1 and lecture 2 will cover the introductory part of an artificial neural network. So let us start with the last topic of the classification of ANN, that is training an artificial neural network. Now see that the most important characteristics of an artificial neural network is its ability to learn, that how exactly it acquires knowledge. Learning in both biological and artificial neural networks is undergoing intense research. The basic questions regarding the human learning process are that how do we learn, which is the most efficient process for learning, how much and how fast can we learn, and what are the hindrances in this learning process. So let us first understand the basic definition of learning or training. So let us go through the definition in brief. Now see that the learning or training is a process in which the network adjusts its parameters, that is nothing but the synaptic waves as we had seen in the biological neuron, in response to the input stimuli, so that the actual output response converges to the desired output response. Basically, we start training the network in a way that whatever the output response, that must equals to the desired response. Once the actual response is equal to the desired response, then the training is being done. And we find that the network has acquired the knowledge. So the problem can be solved using an ANN. Once whatever the desired output is being matched with the actual output of the system. So after going through the definition, let us go with the different categories. So, learning or training algorithms can be categorized as, that is, supervised training, unsupervised training and reinforced training. So let us first discuss supervised training in detail. In supervised training, let us first go through with the block diagram. As the name is supervised training, in supervised training, there is a teacher which will supervise the whole system. So the error signal of the system is being reduced, or the overall error of the system is being reduced by a teacher or a supervisor in a system. That's why the name is supervised learning. In this process, actually, an input vector is being given to a system, and eventually we'll get an output vector. The pair of input vector and output vector will make a learning pair, and that learning is being done under supervision. What exactly is being done in a supervised learning is that the actual response and the desired response are being subtracted to get an error signal. If they are not same, then the difference of that is being calculated and we will get the error signal. Now, that error signal is being removed by the learning mechanism. Okay, that is done in presence of a supervisor or a teacher in this kind of neural network. That's why the name is supervised learning. In case of unsupervised learning, there is no teacher. So, how exactly the learning or training is being done in unsupervised learning? So, in absence of a teacher or a supervisor, whatever the inputs which are being given to a system, that inputs are to be classified. A separate classes are being made in which the particular input will come. Depending on the class, the output can be predicted. If it is found that the input which is being given to a system is not belonging to any class which is already being given, then a new class is being defined. So, in unsupervised training, classification is required, in which the inputs are being classified depending on shape, color, or some other parameter. If the set of classification rules or the rules for grouping the inputs are not provided correctly, then the training is not possible in unsupervised training. The reinforced training is same as supervised training, but the basic difference is in the team. In reinforced training, teacher will not suggest how close the actual output is with desired output. Instead of that, the teacher only suggests the pass or the failure of the match between the actual and the desired value. Means the error in reinforced training is binary in nature. Means the output that we will get, that is in terms of binary digits, it can be 0 or it can be 1. Means in reinforced training, the output that we will get, the error signal that we will get is binary in nature. So that is all about the training and artificial neural network categories, that is a supervised training, unsupervised training and reinforced training. So let us proceed further. With the Megalopitz neural model. Now see that Baron Macalow and Walter Pitts presented the first mathematical model of a single idealized biological neuron in 1943. And this model is also known as, that is the Macalow-Pitts model. Now, this model is quite simple because it does not require learning or adoption. So, learning and adoption is not required in Macalow-Pitts model. The neurons are binary activated, means if the neuron fires, it has an activation of 1, and if neuron does not fire, it has an activation of 0. Means it is binary activated. So depending on the firing condition, it will give logic 1 and logic 0. Now see that in this particular neural model, the neurons are connected by directed weighted paths. Means whatever the input that we will give on the input side, they are being connected to the output layer by some weighted paths. Now there are two types of connections are being there, that is excitatory or inhibitory. The excitatory connection has positive weights and inhibitory connection has negative weights. Each neuron has a fixed threshold such that if net input to the neuron is greater than the threshold, the neuron should fire. Every neuron is being set with a threshold value, means the firing condition. Only if that is met, only then the neuron will fire and give the information. Otherwise, it will not. The threshold is set such that the inhibition is absolute. So, a Macalow-Pitts neural model is shown in this figure. So, we are having a neuron which receives n signals, that is x1, x2, xn, that is excitatory connections are being shown over here, and m signals, that is xn plus 1, xn plus m through inhibitory connections. The weights for excitatory connections are, that is w, that are positive, and for inhibitory connections are, these are the negative weights, that is shown as minus p, and the positive weights are shown by w. So these are the weights which are being connected from the input side to the output side. Now see that the excitatory path has weight, that is w, greater than 0, and the inhibitory connection path has weight minus p, as we had seen in the neural model. And finally, the output equation that we will get, a nonlinear function of y in is equal to, we'll get this binary value, it can be 1 or 0 depending on the threshold condition. So we are having f of y is equal to 1 if y is greater than equal to theta, and 0 if y is less than theta. So this is the output equation, where y in is the total input signal received by neuron y, and theta is the threshold, as we had already discussed this thing in lecture 1. The condition for absolute inhibition is that theta must be greater than nw minus p, and neuron y will fire if it receives k or more excitatory signals and no inhibitory inputs, i.e. that is kw is greater than equal to theta greater than k plus 1 w. So these are the conditions for absolute inhibition. Let us proceed further in the discussion and let us go for the implementation of Michaelopitch network for logic functions. So let us first start with AND function. Now, as we know that, if you are aware of the basic digital electronics AND functions, if both the inputs are at logic 1, then we will get the output logic 1. For rest of the input cases, the output is 0. So that will be the truth value for AND function. Okay. So to make a or to implement a Michaelopitch network for logic function, we will have this kind of model for AND function. So we are having two inputs, x1 and x2, that is being given, and we'll get a net weight, that is y in, and the non-linearity function of y in will give you y. Now initially we are considering the threshold for the neuron y is 2, and the synaptic weights between this is we are taking 1. Okay. So from this figure, let us see how the AND function is being implemented. Now see that the output of the neuron y can be written as, that is y is equal to f of y in is equal to 1 if y in is greater than equal to 2, and 0 if y in is less than 2, where y in is equal to x1 plus x2 as the weights are 1 in this case. To prove this, we will go back towards to the figure, and we will calculate for first case, like if we are taking x1 is equal to x2 is equal to 1, then y in, that is your x1 plus x2, will get 2. So from this output equation we will get y. So this condition is being true, so we will get y in is equal to 1. In the same way, if we take the next case, that is if x1 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 0, then y in will become 1, that is 1 plus 0, weights we are considering 1, 1. The y in equation is x1 plus x2, the same thing. Then we will get y in is equal to 1, and from this equation we will get y is equal to 0, as y in is less than equal to 2. So if we check this equation for all the input condition, it is 2. That is the reason why we are taking the weights 1, 1. So we can write y in is equal to x1 plus x2, and from that we will get the output y is equal to f of y in is equal to 1 if y in is greater than equal to 2, and if y in is less than 2. So you can check for the other cases also, and from that you will get the output equation for the neuron, and we can model it by the figure that I had shown in the previous slide. So that is the implementation of AND function using Michaelopitch neural model. Let us proceed further in the discussion, and let us start with the OR function implementation. For OR function implementation, the truth value for OR is, for x1, x2, 0, 0, we will get 0. For all the other cases, the output will be 1. And the threshold for the neuron y, we are taking it 2. So let us see the output equation and a Michaelopitch neural model for this. So we are taking inputs x1, x2, and we are taking y. The weights initially are being taken as 2, 2, and y, we'll see why we have taken this as 2, 2. Okay, so this is for OR function. Let us see the equation. Now see that the output of the neuron y is written as, that is, y is equal to f of y in is equal to 1 if y in is greater than or equal to 2 and 0 if y in is less than 2, where y in is twice of x1 plus twice of x2. If we consider this weights only, then it is following the OR function. That is the reason why we are taking the weights 2, 2 instead of 1, 1 that we have taken in the AND function. So for first case, if we take x1 and x2 1, our y in will become 4, so y we will get 1 for this case. In the same way, if we take x1 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 0, then y in will become 2 from this equation, and y is equal to fy in will get 1, because obviously y in is equal to 2, so we will get 1. In the same way, if we take x1 and x2 0, 0, then y in will become 0 and y is equal to f of y in will become 0 from this equation. So, it is following the OR function, okay. So, this is the implementation of OR function using Michaelopitts neural model. Let us go through with few more examples. Let us try to make a NOT function. For a NOT, the truth value is, for 1 we will get 0 and for 0 we will get 1. That is for a NOT function. So let us go for the implementation using Michaelopitts neural model. For a NOT function, the threshold value for the output neuron is 1 and the output of the neuron y is given by, that is, y is equal to f of y in will get 1 if y in is less than 1 and 0 if y in is greater than or equal to 1, where y in is equal to x1. So let us see the proof. Now this is the implementation, the x1 will get y in, and from that we will get y after applying a non-linearity function. The weight we are providing as 1. So if x1 is equal to 1, then y in will become 1 because y in is equal to x1. So y is equal to f of y in, we will get 0 from the output equation. In the same way, if x1 is equal to 0, then y in will become 0, then y is equal to f of y in is equal to 1 that we have seen in the output equation. So let us go through the output equation once again. That in the output equation, what we have suggested, that f of y in is equal to 1 if y in is less than 1. So that we are going through in the next slide. So and 0 if y in is greater than or equal to 1. So by going through the two cases, we find that the output equation that we had suggested and the model that is being made is correct after going through these two cases. That's why we are going for a weight of 1 in this case. So after going through the NOT function implementation, let us proceed further with AND NOT implementation. The truth value for the AND NOT is like that if the first input is true and the second input is false, means the first input is at logic 1 and the second input is at logic 0, then the output will be at logic 1. In all other cases, the output will be at logic 0. So let us go with the implementation. Now see that for this, the threshold value for the output neuron is 2. output of the neural Y that we can take as Y is only a function of Y is equal to 1 if Y in is less is greater than 1 and 0 if Y in is less than equal to 1. So this is the implementation where Y in is equal to 2x1 minus x2. So we are having x1, the weight is given 2, and x2 we are giving minus 1. Okay, so we will get the net signal and the non-linearity applied on the net signal, so we will get the final output signal. So let us see the proof for the output equation. Now see that if we apply x1 and x2 is equal to 0, then we will get y in is equal to 0. Because it is 2x1 minus x2. And y is equal to f of y, we will get 0. That is matching with the truth value of n not function. If x1 is equal to 0 and x2 is equal to 1, then we will get y is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to f of y is 0. So that is also following the truth value. If x1 is 1 and x2 is 0, then we know that the output that we will get is 1 for n not. Then y is equal to 2 and y is equal to f of y and will get 1. In the same way, for the last case, if x1 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 1, then y we will get 1 and y is equal to f of y will get 0. So, for all the cases, we find that our output equation is following the all the input cases. Okay, so that is the n not implementation using Mokolovitz neural model. And let us finally go with the last implementation, that is for XOR. For XOR function, we know that if both the inputs are identical, then the output is 0. If they are not identical, then the output is at logic 1. That is the XOR function. Let us go with the implementation. So, the XOR function can be written as, that is y is equal to x1 and not x2 or x2 and not x1. Okay? In this equation, if we assume let x1 and not x2 is z1 and z2 is equal to x2 and not x1. So the equation y can be written as z1 or z2. And we can implement the Mokolovitz neural model for XOR function as we are having x1, x2. So in between we can put z1, z2. That is nothing but x1 and not x2 and x2 and not x1. So that we can connect as we have done in the n not gate. Okay, the weights will be 2 and minus 1. In this case it is 2 and minus 1 for z2. And then, from that, we are supposed to implement an OR function. So that is 2, 2 and we will get the output 1. So, let us go through the cases. So the output of the neuron, that is Zi for I is equal to 1, 2 is, that is, we will get Zi is equal to F of Z in I, so we will get 1, if z in I is greater than or equal to 2 and if 0, if z in I is less than 2. So the output of the neuron y is equal to f of y, we will get 1, if y is greater than or equal to 2 and 0 if y is less than 2. Okay, where z in 1 is equal to 2x1 minus x2 and z in 2 is 2x2 minus x1. And y in is 2z1 plus 2z2, that is the AND NOT function and that is the OR function that we had seen. Okay, so if we take x1 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 0, then putting the values in this equation we will get z in 1 is 2, then we will get z1 is 1 z into will get minus 1, so z1 will get 0. Okay, in the same way z in will get 2, so y of f of y in will get 1. Similarly, we can verify the other input conditions also for the XOR function. So this is the Mokolov-Pitts neural model implementation of logic functions, and we had implemented AND, OR, NOT, AND NOT, and XOR function. So let us proceed further with the applications of neural networks. So depending on the various categories in which we can apply the neural network for the problem solving, so we are having the first category as classification. So we can apply neural networks for the classification purpose, like for the classification of signals of a sonar or a radar, or classification of handwritten alphabets or typewritten alphabets. So that kind of classification application can be done using neural networks. After then, we are having signal processing. So the neural networks can be used in signal processing to reduce the noise signal, to eliminate the error signal, or to reduce the noise signal. So it is being applied in signal processing also. In the same way, for the noise removal in speech recognition. In medicine, there are systems which are being evolved because of the neuron network development and research in this field. So based on the database comprising of the symptoms, the treatment which is being provided to the client or the patient, depending on that, a whole database is being made, and if someone wants to use that for his or her cure, they can put the symptoms and they will get the different treatments. So that kind of learning process and that kind of systems can be developed in medicine. Then we are having intelligent control, a function approximation, financial forecasting, condition monitoring, process monitoring and control, neuro forecasting, and pattern analysis. So these are the fields of application of neural networks. Okay. So let us proceed further with the comparison of an artificial neural network with a biological network. So let us first compare the speed. So here we have taken the biological network, as that is the brain, and an artificial neural network. So to process something, as in the lecture 1, we have suggested that it is a non-linear complex parallel processor. So the processing speed is much more than that of the normal computers which are available in market. So the speed is in few milliseconds, okay, and few nanoseconds for massive parallel processing. There are few processors which are being available which will do the processing in nanoseconds. Size and complexity: 10 raised to 11 neurons and 10 raised to 15 interconnections are there. In ANN, it depends on design. Storage capacity: they can store information in its interconnection or in synapse, so no loss of memory is there. In ANN, the contiguous memory locations are there, and loss of memory may happen sometime. As far as the tolerance is concerned, the brain has fault tolerance. Okay. As far as ANN is concerned, no fault tolerance. Okay. In fact, it gets disrupted when interconnections are disconnected. Okay. So brain is much more fault tolerant than the artificial neural networks, and the control mechanism, that is the complicated, involves chemicals in biological neuron. In case of ANN, it is much more simpler as far as the control mechanism is there. So this is a very basic comparison between an artificial neural network and a biological neuron. So that is all we have for today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will discuss few more models of artificial neural network. Thank you.